This is Mark Meadows.
Well, hello, deplorables! Man, I love you guys!
He was Donald Trump's White House chief of staff.
The committee investigating the January 6th riot and insurrection is now on the brink of a new fight with another of Trump's top lieutenants, former Trump chief of staff Mark Meadows. He was originally subpoenaed back in late September. He's been negotiating with investigators. But tonight, the chairman gave him an ultimatum. In a letter, the panel insists he appear to turn over documents to give a deposition tomorrow, 10 a.m., or, quote, the select committee will view Mr. Meadows' failure to appear at the deposition as willful noncompliance.
Mark Meadows was subpoenaed by Congress in order to show up to testify about the events that unfolded leading up to and during the January 6th insurrection. Now, Mark Meadows has refused to show up and as a result could face criminal contempt if he is referred to the Department of Justice, but also it would depend on the Justice Department actually acting on those criminal contempt charges, which is unfortunately proving itself to be a very difficult challenge because it seems as though the Justice Department is choosing to sit on its hands instead of aggressively pursuing these contempt charges against the individuals that are being subpoenaed by Congress to show up and testify. Now, Mark Meadows is trying to claim that he should be covered by executive privilege, but that does not apply for two different reasons. First and foremost, Donald Trump is not presently the president of the United States of America, so he cannot exert any type of executive privilege because he is no longer the executive. Secondly, executive privilege is not meant to be a blanket protection from any type of subpoenas. Congress has the authority to subpoena people for a very specific reason. They should have oversight over the executive branch, which means they have to have subpoena power over the executive branch. It's also worth noting that the only reason executive privilege exists in the first place is because once upon a time, George Washington thought that it was really annoying to have to go to Congress every single day to testify in front of them about what the government was doing. He was basically like, hey, I have to do my job, and if I have to do my job, I can't be testifying in front of Congress every single day, so give me a break. From that, this entire legal framework was born. The most frustrating part of this, though, is that there's well-established case law pointing to the fact that Congress does have the authority to subpoena people from the executive branch, and the Department of Justice is well within its rights to have arrested anybody that is in contempt. But unfortunately, they are going out of their way to just wait for these federal courts to make decisions about these things, which should have very clear answers because, from a constitutional standpoint, they do have very clear answers. So it is actually a serious puzzle as to why the Department of Justice is choosing to sit on their hands and slow roll everything around this January 6th insurrection. We are already near the end of the first year of Joe Biden's presidency, which means there's 3 years on the clock. You know what we can't do is wait until there's several more elections to figure out who all was involved in this January 6th insurrection. But in all likelihood, it is probably going to happen before the next election. And if these Republicans choose not to comply with these subpoenas, they could very much find themselves in jail. Now, Mark Meadows is a person of interest for the very specific reason of him being in the room with the president of the United States during the January 6th insurrection. He would have pretty clear and direct knowledge about what Donald Trump was up to that day. He would probably also have, being the White House chief of staff, pretty clear and direct knowledge about what other people were up to during that day. Pretty critical person with critical information. And I also want to take a second to point out the absolute hypocrisy of this person not showing up to this hearing, because this is somebody that has a very long record of saying that people should be punished for doing things. This is a guy who thinks that there should definitely be consequences for actions. Like, for example, right here.
Trump's former White House chief of staff, Mark Meadows, is calling out the 13 Republican congressmen who voted in favor of the bipartisan infrastructure bill. In fact, he's going so far as to say that these individuals should be punished by GOP leadership.
You saying, sir, that you would strip these people of their committees?
Absolutely. Listen, they stripped Marjorie Taylor Greene of her committees for not even voting against the Republican Party. These people voted for Joe Biden for an infrastructure bill that will clear the way for more socialist spending that, quite frankly, gives Joe Biden a win.
You know, yeah. So when Republicans vote for a bipartisan bill, that is somehow what they should be punished for. But if the White House chief of staff might have played a role in a literal attempted coup, then that's just drawing the line too far. Like, are we joking here? Since it looks like the Build Back Better agenda is basically dead at this point, this would be a really opportune moment for Joe Biden to refocus his presidency on at very least figuring out what happened on January 6th and figuring out to what degree Donald Trump himself was personally involved. And just as an aside, you might note that the other person in that podcast was also subpoenaed, which was Steve Bannon, and he also didn't show up to Congress. So that's a fun little tidbit of information. This is Ben Carolla with Rebel Headquarters. You can catch my show Galaxy Brain on the Young Turks Twitch channel every Friday at 4 p.m. Eastern Time. You can follow me on Twitter if you want to stay up to date with my content.